Hey there, and welcome back to a series that I'm actually bringing back. It's been 2 or 3 years, I think, since I started this one. This is how to make a Pokémon fan game using Pokémon Scripting Development Kit, also known as PSDK. That's how we're just going to be referencing it from now on. So, PSDK is similar to Pokémon Essentials in a sense that you're going to be using RPG Maker XP to make a Pokémon game, or make your game, whatever you want to call it. I guess you can technically just make it a monster taming game. It doesn't have to be Pokemon. There's a few people that are using PSDK that are making commercial games, and they go over what you have to do in the Discord. But there's been some big changes to PSDK, and so I'm deciding to redo this video. Previously, you would just download PSDK, I believe, from the Discord or from like, you know, a website. Now you actually download Pokémon Studio. You're going to need an installer that you're going to get from their GitHub, and you're just going to run it, install it, and it's going to install it to your desktop. It should instantly launch the program, and from there, we're going to make our project. It's super simple, and that's really all we're going to go over in this video. So with that being said, the first thing we're going to need to do is go to the GitHub. This is going to be linked in the description. Also could be found over on the Discord, which is also going to be found in the description. Just 2 days ago, there was an update for version 1.02 for Pokemon Studio. I believe it had added quite a few things, but the most noticeable thing for me was that it added in the percentage chance for effects for moves. So yeah, anyways, they're actively working on Pokemon Studio, and if they find bugs and stuff, you can always report it, and they're pretty quick to fix it, is what I'm trying to get at there. But anyways, like I said, click this link in the description, download the EXE, and then just run it. Once you're done running it, which I have recently downloaded it, but I'll re-download it again. And once it's ready, you just click it. Now, like I said, I have already installed it, so it should be totally safe. I already have it here. I'm gonna hit run anyways, and it's gonna install. It's gonna replace this icon, and it should launch. Like I said, it should launch instantly. I guess we can just wait on that real quick. And just like that, you can see it launched, and it has nice, pretty UI. Previously, this is what RubyHost would do, but now, like I said, we're going to be using Pokemon Studio, which is just such an improvement visually. It actually makes it pretty satisfying to even make new things, like new Pokemon, new items and stuff. So as you see here, these are recent projects. Second generation revamped is a project that my friend is doing named Omega, that is trying to bring like second gen kit to PSDK. So pretty cool stuff there. Pokemon Number is the fan game I've been working on for a while now, and this tutorial project is basically what I tried doing in the first attempt of making this video. We're going to delete that one, and then we're going to do new project, and we're going to do it again. So here, we're going to put in the name of our game, which this one's just going to be tutorial project. You can put in your icon here, and it even recommends the size. I would obviously recommend using PNG, so it has a transparent background, but that's up to you. And then even here, you can use multilingual if you want to use multiple languages, or you can just do the default language if you're just using one, which for the sake of the video, we're just going to do one. I'm not going to go over importing an existing project just because that has some complications in terms of a lot of people not updating their scripts. So if you're having issues with importing an existing project, it's probably related to that, and you might just need to, it might just be easier to create a new one, which is kind of what I did. Now, that's not what they're suggesting, but that's what I'm personally suggesting. It wasn't that hard. You can just move over all your things. You've probably maybe even gotten better at organizing if you have an existing project since you've started it. Who knows? But so we're just going to go over creating a regular project. And we're going to delete this one. So that might take a bit. Our PSDK tutorial project folder, it's on my desktop. This is just going to be wherever you want your project folder to go to. I think it's pretty convenient to make one on your desktop and just put it in there. That's what we're going to do. And this takes a little bit. It's going to be giving you all the game files, all the audio files, all the data files, pictures, etc., UI, you know, all that stuff. So this takes a little bit, and just like that, it's ready. Some stuff that I'm going to go over very quickly, but not into any depth yet. You can actually change your project here. You can change things like the name of the project in case you changed your mind later, and the project version. I'm not really sure why it starts on 256, but you can start on 1, whatever you want to do, it's up to you. You can also do your project icon here in case you didn't do it in the beginning. It doesn't give you the recommended size anymore, but just remember it's 128 by 128. And then here is where you can add in more languages. Also, in case you changed your mind, originally, if you maybe selected you're not going to use multi-language, you can always just change it here. Other things to go over, you can actually update PSDK from Pokémon Studio now. So you're pretty much doing everything in Pokémon Studio. Eventually, the goal is to replace RPG Maker, but at the moment, you still need Pokémon Studio. You actually kind of need Ruby Host for some things, but not too many things yet, and so I'm not going to go too into detail on that yet until we get to it. But for the most part, you're pretty much just using Pokémon Studio and RPG Maker to make your events and stuff. Back over here is where we actually modify the data. We have the Pokémon data here, which is so beautifully displayed to you. You can change your forms. You can even add new forms. You can change the Pokémon here. You can change a lot of information. You can view a ton of information here. You can change it, the Pokemon from here, and it updates. It's awesome. You can just go to the moves and you can scroll through moves. You can even type in here what move you want to look at. Like, let's say we want to look at Hyper Beam. Boom. You can even see the Pokemon that learn it. Like, it's pretty cool stuff. It's a great upgrade from Ruby Host, and we even have abilities, types, items, all that stuff. And all of these things I'll go over in future videos in a lot more detail. I'm really excited to go over it because I know some people were asking about how to make new Pokemon, and now it's just even easier than it was before. Not that it was ever complicated, but now it's just so much easier that it's going to be actually pretty fun to go over. So with that being said, I think I'm going to end the video here, as this is supposed to be a pretty basic video of just how to get started with PSDK. So with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.